Now comes the second order reaction. So if I consider an equation, so this is the elementary reaction for the second order. At time 0, the concentration is A, and at time t, the concentration is right. So the rate is directly proportional to the square of concentration. So if I write the rate, that is equal to so this is a differential rate law equation for the second order equation. If I solve this equation, the equation comes out to be kt equals to 1 upon at minus 1 upon a naught. This at is equals to a minus x. So this is the equation for the second order reaction. Also, the one term is used, that is fraction of condensation. This term means x divided by a, this divided by initial concentration. This is fraction of condensation. Now comes the half-life period for the second order reaction. The half-life for the second order reaction is equal to 1 upon Ka. So this is the formula for the half-life period for the second order reaction. Next is the quarter life. Quarter life is equals to thrice of T half. So this is the formula for quarter life. This is for the half-life. Okay, next is T completion. T completion for the second order is also equal to infinite, which means second order is never completed. So next comes the graphical part for the second order reaction. So the first graph is graph between 1 upon Ct, that is concentration of a time versus time period. So if I see the equation is 1 upon Ct minus 1 upon C naught, that is equal to K naught. Okay, so the equation can be written as Kt plus 1 upon C naught. So this is the equation for the straight line graph. This is intercept. This is slope. Slope here is positive. So the graph is like this. So next graph is a graph for the half-life. So if I see the equation for the half-life, half-life for the second order reaction is equal to 1 upon Ka. Right, and we have to calculate the graph between T half versus A. So if we see T half into A, that is equal to 1 upon K, which is equal to constant. So the graph comes out like this. Okay, so this is the graph between T half versus A. But if the graph is asked between T half versus 1 upon A, as according to the equation, T half equals to 1 upon Ka. And we have to calculate the graph between T half versus 1 upon A. So this is the equation for the straight line graph, y equals to mx plus c. So intercept here is 0, means the straight line passed through the origin. Slope is 1 upon K. So the graph is like this. T half versus 1 upon A. Here asked between A and here is 1 upon A. So this is the graph of the half-life period for the zero order reaction. So this is all about the second order reaction. So next comes the third order reaction. Now I write the equation, elementary equation for the third order reaction. At time 0, the concentration is, and at time t, the concentration is A minus X, A minus X, A minus X, and here X. So the rate is directly proportional to the cube of concentration, right? So if I write the rate for the third order reaction, this comes out to be K3 A minus X raised to power 3. So this is the differential rate law equation for the third order reaction. If I solve this equation, the equation comes out to be K3T, that is equal to 1 upon A minus X square minus 1 upon A naught ka square or 1 upon A square, right? This can also be written as 1 upon AT square minus 1 upon A naught ka square K3T. So this is the integrated rate law equation for the third order reaction. So next comes the T half for the third order reaction. T half for the third order reaction is 3 by 2 A square K. So this is the formula for the T half for the third order reaction. Next is the quarter time period, which is equal to 5 of T half. So this is quarter life period and half life period for the third order reaction. So next comes the graphical representation for the third order reaction. The first graph is between 1 upon Ct square versus time. So the equation is K3T equals to 1 upon Ct square minus 1 upon C naught square. So this is the generalized equation for the third order reaction. So which is equal to K3T equals to 1 upon Ct square minus 1 upon C naught square. So 1 upon Ct square is equal to 2 K3T plus 1 upon C naught square. So this is the straight line equation graph. This is intercept. Right? This is slope. Slope is positive. So the graph is 1 upon Ct square versus time. The graph is like this, straight line with positive slope. So the next graph for the third order reaction is the graph for the half life. Now the first graph is T half versus A. So if I write the equation is T half equals to 3 by 2 1 upon K3 1 upon A square. So this is the graph for the hyperbola with even powers, that is this considered as a C 1 upon X square. So this is of this type graph. So this is 1 upon X square, C is constant, which is equal to C. So this is the graph for the hyperbola with even powers, means the graph is sharply decreasing, that is. So this is the first graph of T half versus A. Next graph is T half versus A square. So this is T half versus A square. So again, if I write the equation, T half equals to 3 by 2 1 upon K3 1 upon A square. Now consider it as a X. So T half equals to, this is constant, so C 1 upon X. This is as Y. So Y equals to C 1 upon X, which is equals to YX equals to C. So this is the graph for hyperbola with odd powers, means it is less sharply decreasing. So the graph is like this. Okay. Next graph is T half versus 1 upon A. So T half equals to 3 by 2 1 upon K3 1 upon A square. And we need 1 upon A. So Y equals to x c square. This is as x c square y. So this is the parabola type graph. So the graph is okay. Next graph is the t-half versus 1 upon a square. T-half equals to 3 by 2 1 upon k3 1 upon a square. So we have to draw the graph between t-half versus 1 upon a square. So this is the equation for the straight line graph type, y equals to mx plus c plus 0. So the slope here is 3 by 2 1 upon k3. So the graph is straight line passing through the origin with the positive slope. So this is all about the graphical representation for the third order reaction.